Yeah, I'm Jamie Washell. I'm the Deputy Fire Chief at Bloomington Fire Department in Bloomington, Indiana. And we're here to do a final inspection on our HR 100-foot stick ladder truck. Bloomington, Indiana is the home of Indiana University, so we have about 50,000 students. It's one of the top 10 largest universities in the country. We serve a population of, in 2010, about 85,000, so we expect to probably close to 100,000 people. One of the reasons why we went with the 100-foot HR E1 was the laybacks of the big box buildings that we have in that area, more industrial. The 75-foot was just not enough for us to accomplish operationally what we needed to in case of a major emergency, which we had one about 3 years ago with a box store. One of the things that we operationally look at on the west side is we're using this as sort of a quint, where we're going to use this as an engine company and then also a ladder company, in the possibility that our other ladder is at another emergency call. But the other thing we're looking at is an elevated master stream. This gives us the ability, especially downtown Bloomington, where our buildings are growing up a lot taller because we haven't annexed in 20 years. So a lot of our, we've gained probably millions of square foot in the air and not a single foot, from a standpoint of our area growing on that footprint. So one of the things that we really like about this is it gives us the ability to be an engine company and then also have that ability to do a high rise rescue with that ladder that's 100 feet, and then also the ability to have that elevated master stream. With the E1 HR 100, now we have an 11-foot footprint. And in Bloomington, Indiana, where we're really trying to, we really have a lot of pedestrian traffic, especially with the ball games and things like that. And our streets are kind of getting more narrow. I don't know if you're seeing that in your communities, but ours is definitely happening like that. One of the things that we looked at is how can we safely be able to elevate our ladder, our master stream if we need to, and shorten our footprint. This gives us a foot and a half on each side, to keep it safe and for our operators here and our firefighters to effectively and safely do an operation. The one thing that I can tell you with dealing with fire service and E1 and then standardizing our fleet with all E1 with the prices of repairs and the mechanical processes and dealing with our fleet director, standardizing that fleet was really something that we thought we could save a little bit of money with. And then also keep our engines and our trucks back online and get them back in service as quickly as we could because of the delays that we were having with four or five different kinds of pieces of equipment and different vendors. Now we have one vendor. The process itself is this has been really, really smooth. Dave Thomas from Fire Service Incorporated is excellent to work with. I can call or I can have my logistics officer call Dave Thomas almost any time of day, and I know things are going to get done. They're going to get done the right way, and they're going to be done efficiently, and we're going to be able to get our folks back on the line and our apparatus back in service. And so the process itself, I think, has been great. Obviously a beautiful new ladder truck we have, but again, 2 years from now, the service is going to be what matters to me most and to our people, to get that back in service and quickly and safely. And that's what we've dealt with fire service in E1.